I set up a group called the Buy Black Movement, I think in 2018. We've got a WhatsApp group now. We created a Facebook group as well, which I think is close to 9,000 members now. I think over the course of the years that we've had about maybe 20 to 25,000 rand in contributions from members. And obviously, we were struggling to get members to join. I think it's a lesson for me to build better systems to get people to sign up with debit orders. Why did I set up the Buy Black Movement? I wanted something to compete with AfriForum. I love what AfriForum is doing for Afrikaans-speaking people. And I think as of late, I saw that they've now got their own private security company over and above the fact that they are building or they have built a university for 300 million. AfriForum, I think, has over 200,000 members, I could be wrong, who contribute an average of about 100 rand each per month. You can do the math of how much they get from there. So I wanted to create something similar with maybe 1,000, 10,000 black people contributing 100 rand a month so that we're getting 100,000 to 1 million rand a month. Use that money to invest in black businesses. Use that money to promote buying from black businesses and why it's important for the average black person to support a black-owned business. Why black people must choose to work for black businesses and how we can ensure that we do things better so we can build a black economy and make sure that money stays within the country and within the black communities rather than going to Asia, going to America, going to Europe, and going to white communities and enriching white and Asian communities in South Africa who maybe don't reinvest in the black communities. I'm making this video because I'm reminded of another very important reason why I set up the Buy Black Movement. There's a huge lack of financial literacy, especially in the black community. We don't understand how money works. We don't understand where money comes from. We don't understand the rand to the dollar to the yen. We don't know what reserve banks and central banks do and how they operate. We don't understand business. We don't understand debt. We don't understand profit margins, pricing, rent, location. There's so many things we don't understand about money as a concept. And I was hoping to use the platform to teach black people about money, number one. Number two, I wanted to teach black business owners how to deal with clients. A lot of our black businesses are bashed every day on social media because of bad service. And to be honest, they haven't been trained. How do you deal with a customer, whether black or otherwise, who has received bad service from you? How do you apologize? How do you make sure that you remain calm and patient and understanding while they shout at you and swear at you, while they drag your name on social media and they call you names and they threaten you via DMs? How do you deal with that? How do you rectify? And if you can't rectify their issue, how do you try and find a way to make sure that it doesn't happen again? But at least be honest, we can't fix your problem, we can't refund you, we don't have the funds, this is what's happened, etc. And let the customer know so that even if they're angry and they're miserable, at least you are able to communicate. Because communicating is one of the big things that black businesses struggle at, knowing how to effectively communicate, picking up phone calls, responding to SMSs and WhatsApps, sending voice notes, communicating on social media. And explaining that, look, our company is currently going through this problem. Can customers please understand? On the other hand, and we don't speak much about this, teaching black customers how to approach businesses, all businesses, but especially black businesses, understanding the history of where we come from an economic perspective, so that and such that when you engage a black business, you have the sensitivity and the empathy to understand this is probably a new business. Person's probably not as financially savvy. They probably haven't priced correctly. They probably don't know what's happening with their competitors. And then going there and teaching this black business or this black business owner, this is what you're doing wrong. This is why the white business is better than you. This is why the Asian business is better than you. Try and consider this. What are your policies around that? Please speak to your customer, to your workers about their customer service. Please deal with things like this when it comes to refunds and complaints. And in that way, we can hold each other accountable because complaining is very important. It's how you ensure that standards of service improve. Keeping each other accountable as customers, keeping each other accountable as business owners. And if we can work together, understanding where we come from and understanding the different racial groups that we're fighting against in the business world and why they're better and why they price cheaper. And why their service is better, etc. And understanding that and saying, look, we want to get to the same level, but we need to be patient with each other. We need to work with each other. Why? Because if we empower black businesses, we keep money within the country, which allows us to improve our infrastructure, our roads, our homes, our healthcare. And then it also helps us create jobs for black people. Because every time you buy from a Chinese import, you're sending jobs to China. Every time you buy an Apple iPhone, you're sending jobs to America. Every time you buy a BMW, you're sending jobs to Germany, etc., etc., etc. We're not creating jobs locally. And everything we buy from sends money outside the country. If it's not outside the country, then we're sending money to other neighborhoods, Indian neighborhoods, Chinese neighborhoods, white neighborhoods in South Africa, and we're killing our black neighborhoods. And then we wake up the next day wondering, why do we not have jobs? Why are our businesses fucked? It's because it starts with the individual. I set up the group, and look, I want to leave it because I think the work that I'm trying to do is too deep. It's too far. And number two, a lot of black people are really mentally broken, and I don't know if I have the capacity and the patience to work through that. And then number three, I'm not getting paid for the work that I'm doing. And unfortunately, I'm not rich. I used to have money, my business fucked out. I'm still trying to rebuild. But I'm not rich, and I'm not getting paid to help black people uplift themselves. Government gets paid through tax. NGOs get paid either from government or from private companies. Companies make money from their profits. I'm not getting paid. So at some point, because I have children, because I need to eat, I need to ask myself, is this work that I'm doing worth it if I'm not getting paid for it? And how do I fix that? But this is just me telling you guys that it's very important to understand the dynamics that black businesses are dealing with. To understand as black business owners, the mindset of the black customer, the black consumer, the black client, and how we need to come together and work with each other to try and win in the future. Otherwise, we'll never make it. And if we're never going to make it, we need to accept as blacks, we suck at business, we suck at customer service. Let's either go back to the rurals and plant our own vegetables and look after chickens and live in mud huts, or let's go work for whites and Indians and the Chinese and accept that we really, really suck at business. Maybe in 2-3 generations' time, some of our kids or our grandkids will then have learned how business works, and maybe they'll be ready. But for now, we're not. But I don't know if we're ready for that conversation because it's very difficult. Penny Wilder, Black Pen. I love you guys very much. Happy Friday. Cheers.